Blackbeard kind of sucks at hiding these things. Let's see what these things can do. Running out of juice. Another clue. Gotta get to that chest now that I found all the glyphs. Better be good.
Souls Orientation Guide, Chapter 17, The Battlegrounds. This graveyard is where dead of the previous war on Heaven were buried. Here it is rumored that demons and angels alike haunt this place to be very dead.
Play too?
Yeah.
Slumlord. Now, face Luvard.
My regards to your boss. All right, it's salvation time. Satan's using his magic to send souls skyward and downward into oblivion. That's where you come in. Catch the falling souls before they hit ground and use an arcane blast to free the souls rising upward. Of course, once you do that, you'll still have to catch them before they drift off to their death. Speed is key here. You'll get a bonus for every soul you can save before touching down. Now let's go save some clients. I mean souls. Poor souls that need help.
Probably a bad guy anyway.
Gotta pick it up.
He was probably a bad guy anyway.
If I want to keep the momentum going, I gotta stay in the air. Yeah! Thank you, baby.
Thank you.
Need the rest of wings. Running out of juice.
I lose the combo when I touch the ground? How gamey is that?
Damn it. God, this feels good. Well, looky here.
The Forge is prime real estate in Hell. This smoggy shithole is located over the richest mineral veins in the afterlife. You want to hurt Hell's infrastructure? Here's where you do it.
I'm not into Shakespeare's whole creepy mask thing. Reminds me too much of that sex party I went to.
See what these things can do. Gotta find more of these things.
My lawyer, Legal Lee, figured out a way to get some gold-level clients a fast track out of Hell. The more abuse you put these guys through, the more years we can shave off. Lee suggested running clients through the designated intersections to boost their punishment. Oh, and dive in front of those vehicles on fire for bonus points. I mean, let's face it, the more they hurt, the sooner we can get these wretched bastards out of here.
While his wife Laura was admitted into heaven, the Heavenly Father was less forgiving of poor Tobias, whose shirtless antics as a crazed drug dealer firmly earned him a place inside the Great Inferno. However, ever the optimist, Tobias tried to look on the bright side of being transformed into a husk. After all, while the removal of his signature dreadlocks was a disappointment, he was finally free from having to wear pants ever again. But while Perpetual Commando appealed to Tobias, he still yearned for Laura and her delightful snickerdoodles. Touched by his story and terrified by his demeanor, Legal Lee worked with renewed purpose to unite the two lovers.
God, this feels good. This is bad timing. Yeah. see what these things can do. This is what I'm talking about.
I'm scared of you.
Souls before I touch down. Let's see what these things can do.
Hope that guy gets a do-over.
Now's the time to collect as many souls as I can. God, this feels good. Okay, Need the rest of wings.
Just entered one of four soul extraction facilities. This is where souls enter hell to have their sins removed and then thrown to the streets to wander for eternity. Now make no mistake, this isn't Satan being magnanimous. Sins are the currency in hell. That means these places are the cornerstone of his income. There's three sections of the facility, and to fully take it over, you need to capture all three. But be careful. Satan's goons are going to be looking to reclaim any section you're not guarding. You pull this off, you'll hurt Satan and Ultor makes money. It's win-win.
Gotta pick it up. Alright.
Great work. Ultor is moving into the territory you freed up, and we're already seeing a difference. I can't wait to see what happens when we own it all. One of these days I'm gonna get Blackbeard off that boat and onto the fucking squash court.
Nice. Isn't over. Shakespeare secretly longed for overt control of the entertainment district. If only someone could act on behalf of the thoughts he kept to himself. The bard knew enough about structure to read the signs. A broken neck, a destroyed planet. Wherever the twins walked, a plot twist was soon to follow.
Winning isn't important. It's the fight.